After a string of building collapses in the last couple of months, the Maharashtra government has now swung into action. It has put in place a new policy to dictate how societies and landlords can reconstruct, redevelop buildings and homes. CNBC TV18's Ashwini Priyolkar and Arundhati Ramanan find out how these norms will actually work.
Mumbai and its suburbs are home to over 600 residential buildings like this one. Buildings that are falling apart and have been designated as uninhabitable by the BMC. After over 50 people were killed due to building collapses in the last few months, especially during or after reconstruction and renovation work, the Maharashtra government is making it more difficult to carry out any such activity that could put lives at risk.
Following uproar over the deaths caused by building collapses, the Maharashtra government has announced a policy for tenanted buildings in suburbs and for non-cess tenanted buildings in the island city. Tenanted buildings are those in which the residents are not the homeowners and pay a rent fixed under the Rent Control Act. This new policy is aimed at increasing their safety.
Essentially, this policy covers buildings where tenants originally took possession of homes before the 13th of June 1996. In these buildings, a landlord can initiate reconstruction or renovation only if at least 70% of the tenants in the entire building give their consent. To incentivize redevelopment, the policy says developers will get 50% extra floor space index in the new building. In case of such redevelopment, the policy states that each tenant be given a unit in the new apartment that is equal to the carpet area occupied by the tenant in the old building, and that this area is, at minimum, 300 square feet and at maximum, 753 square feet. Also, the landlords must begin reconstruction within 1 year from the date of demolition and complete it within 5 years. During this time, the landlord must provide the tenants with alternate accommodation. The policy also mandates that the landlord set up a corpus fund to take care of the maintenance of the building for a period of 10 years. But experts say that this policy still does not offer clarity on a few important issues. The most pressing being whether the landlords will be legally required to transfer title of ownership of the apartments in the redeveloped structure to the tenants. They say that without this, tenants may not give consent for redevelopment. In Mumbai, with Ashwini Priyolkar, Arundhati Ramanan.